guess I'll have to take credit for really introducing Jack to all the black leadership, like Aaron Shirley, Charles Humphrey, Pelton Barnes, Dr. Sanders, and others. But we particularly needed Helen because of her leadership and because she was an OBGYN physician. And as you know, that's one of the reasons that we were in my bio, because it was one of the finest symbols, though segregated, of a black foundation for healthcare. There were two hospitals there, Friendship and Taborin. And unfortunately, because Mississippi was so bad and so separated, the Mississippi Hospital Commission had de-licensed those two hospitals. And everybody, black physicians and black patients, was really crying for help to save those two institutions.
Why did they de-license those hospitals?
Well, that's a long story. Again, one of the reasons that community health centers grew out of Mississippi was the fact that Mississippi was undergoing, if you look back and since slavery, if it wasn't Jim Crow, if it wasn't hangings, if it wasn't changing the Constitution, it was doing whatever Mississippi could do on one hand to empty the state of blacks and to retard the progress of blacks. And in the height of the civil rights movement, just after Brown versus education, most of the southern states developed a new stance. As you can remember, George Wallace in Alabama says, basically, nigger, nigger, never, never, segregation forever. And in Mississippi, the governor said, his position was intersection, interposition, nullification, meaning no damn change. And also at that time, the White Citizen Council had been formed,